Today I'm going to color this black and white image, which I printed on canvas. This was, I shot this a couple of years ago in Encinitas, this shot from the parking lot at Swami's, looking south. So these are the bluffs with the campground at San Elijo State Beach. And in the background here, that's all Solana Beach, and this is Cardiff State Beach right here. I'm going to color it like sunset colors, starting with the sky. I'm going to use oils, and I'm going to use opaque oils for the sky, putting a little color gradient, and then the rest of the image I'm going to color with transparent oils. I'm going to mix titanium white with phthalo blue. Probably not too much, as this is a pretty strong color. And then I'll add a little bit of burnt umber to desaturate it. Usually I use a lot of liquid to make the oil transparent, but I also like to use a little bit for the opaque oils so it dries faster and it changes the consistency, making it more fluid. Here I'm adding a little bit of the burnt umber. And here's some liquid. I'm starting at the top using a 3-inch flat brush. I'm going to add some more white to my blue so I can start on the gradient. And I'm cleaning the brush with some paper towels. I'm starting on the next layer, which I'll blend with the layer above it. Now I'm blending the layers together.
This is another reason I like oil paint, because with acrylics it's very hard to blend the colors well and create this gradient in the sky I'm doing here. Now it's time to add a little bit of red, which makes the paint go towards purple here. Now I added even more red to the already existing mix of paint. And also this layer is then blended with the one above it, making long strokes. Now it's time to make a transition, which I'm going to use more red and also yellow, adding a more orange layer. Now I would like to add a layer that is bright orange. I still would like it more saturated than what I have, so I'm adding even more red and yellow. And here I'm adding a little bit more liquid, but still not too much. I'm also going to use a smaller brush now. I'm using the smaller brush because I'll have to be careful with the palm tree over here. I don't want to paint over it. This is a nice bright color, typical of the beautiful sunsets we have here in California. Sometimes I go over objects in the background, like the palm tree here, and then paint them in from scratch later on, but here I decided to go around it instead. Now I'm blending the layers again to create that smooth transition. Here I'm using an even smaller brush to go around the details of the palm tree. Later I'm going to add a transparent green to the palm tree itself. Actually, all the palm trees will get a little bit more green later on. Here I have added more yellow to the paint mix, so it's turning a little bit more orange. I'm getting close to the horizon and I'm therefore a little more careful keeping my distance because I don't want to completely cover the details in the background with opaque oils. Adding some small clouds to break up the gradient slightly. At this point, I'm going to add a lot of liquid to the mix because I'm going to go transparent. I'm going to use transparent paint. I'm also using a brush now that is typically used for acrylics as the paint is becoming very liquid, very fluid. This is a little too transparent for my taste, so I'm adding a little bit more paint. Now it's okay to go over the horizon because the paint is transparent enough, so I'm effectively coloring the image now. adding some setting sunlight to the palm trees. I do want the houses in the background a little lighter, so I'm using cotton rounds to remove some of the paint. I like that look of the transparent orange for the bluffs too. This serves as the base color for the bluffs, but later I'll add some more burnt sienna to them. The background needs a bit more of that orange. This is Cardiff State Beach right here. More to the foreground, I'm adding the paint on thicker. This is the point where I have added more burnt sienna to the mix, which is actually one of my favorite colors. Burnt sienna is an orangey brown, and I use that color in many of my images. This is a little too much, so I'm using a cotton round again to remove some of it, but also adding it in different areas. That color also looks great on the palm trees, making them stand out a little more compared to the background. When it is low tide, the south end of San Elijo State Beach becomes an excellent beach for bike riding for kids. I have taken my daughter there a couple of times before. Because the slope of the beach is so low, it's also shallow in the ocean for a wide area, making it perfect for playing in the waves. On the beach, I'm adding less color towards the back and come to the foreground, more color, keeping in mind an atmospheric perspective. This is my dog Puffy, hanging out in the front yard. Here is where we are at now. We have done the sky with the sunset. I've added the warm colors to the bluff and the beach. And I still have to finish more down in this area. Later I'm going to add greens to the bluffs and cool blues to the ocean. Now I'm starting with a new clean palette. I'm going to color the ocean with an aquamarine blue, and I'm going to use a lot of liquid again, and phthalo blue and yellow to make that aqua color. I'm using an acrylic brush again. The blue is a strong color, so I'm not using too much of it, but this looks too light, so I'm taking a little bit more. Still a little too light for my taste. This is starting to look good. I'm looking at the thinner layers here, comparing it to the white of the palette, to decide if the paint is too transparent or too opaque. I'm starting with a light transparent aquamarine in the very background on the top here and work my way down again. I'm trying to avoid the areas where the waves break, so I'm keeping those areas nice and white. You can see the color contrast works really nice between the warm and the cool areas. You can see that in much of my other work too. At this point, I'm adding a little more yellow, so the paint gets a little more saturated, thicker, and turns a little more aqua still, now that I'm approaching the foreground. Thank you. I like how in this area here, these two crossing ways are coming together. One from the southwest and one is coming in from the northwest. I'm ready to add some sap green, thinned with a lot of liquid again, to the foliage on the bluffs. Sap green is not too strong of a pigment, so I'm adding a bit more compared to the liquid, more than I would use with phthalo blue. I'm still using a soft brush because the paint is still very fluid. I feel that adding this green completes the image. It doesn't really feel done with just the oranges and the blues. Also, the palm trees really stand out now nicely against the background. Here I'm adding some light blue carefully to Tower 18. And the very last thing to do is to add some light blue to Tower 19 closest to me.
And this is it.
Finished on Halloween.